you and from their faces here today. Something to think about this today and during the week. God is calling you, equipping you, and preparing you according to his purpose. Will you respond? Father, when we say Mass this evening, please stand as we sing.
We are in the season of Advent, a time for us to prepare ourselves before the Lord, the birth of our Lord Jesus. And in the Gospel today, St. John the Baptist inviting us, prepare his path, sorry, prepare his way, and make his path straight. And let us now sign the cross together and also ask the Lord once again, forgive our sins and make us worthy to receive him and celebrating the sacred mystery. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves before we celebrate this sacred mystery. I confess
to my God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have regularly sins and in my thoughts and in my ways, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask this Spirit of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son. But may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us administrance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. snare for those who fear him, and his glory shall dwell in our land.
Since everything is coming to an end like this, you should be living holy and saintly lives while you wait and long for the day of God to come, when the sky will dissolve in flames and the elements melt in heat. What we are waiting for is what he promised, the new heavens, the new earth, the place where righteousness will be at home, so that, my friends, while you are waiting, do your best to live lives without spot or stain, so that he will find you at peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
John wore a garment of camel skin and he lived on locusts and wild honey. In the course of his preaching, he said, Someone is following me, someone who is more powerful than I am, and I am not fit to kneel down and undo the trap of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, 700 years before the coming of Christ, when the kingdom of Israel, founded by King David, was falling apart, God promised that he would not abandon his people. He promised to send a savior, a descendant of King David. And when Christ was born, that promise was fulfilled. Before Jesus began his public ministry, the Holy Spirit sent John the Baptist to make the preparations, to remind the people of Israel of their covenant with the God of heaven and earth, to inform them that the promised Messiah was soon to arrive, and to instruct them about how to get ready. These are the actions of a faithful God, a God who keeps his promises. And just as he keeps his promise to the people of Israel, brothers and sisters, God keep his promise to us too. On the day of our baptism, God promised that he would never abandon us. He adopted us as his children and became our father. He promised that he would never stop sustaining us with his grace, love and truth. As the Catechism put it, at every time and in every place, God drew close to us. And the words of John the Baptist in today's Gospel are reminding us that our God is faithful. We are the privileged one. We are here at Mass today, being reminded of God's faithfulness. We are chosen by God's grace to try and to live this advance meaningfully, turning our attention to God's faithfulness, power and love. Because of that, God is really at work in our hearts, drawing us closer to him, making us wiser, stronger, and creator to be victorious in the battle of life. But what about all those people who are not here today with us? All of our friends, colleagues, family members, strangers, and neighbors who will probably show up for Mass on Christmas Eve, but who are missing out on all the reminders and graces that God is sending us during Advent. They too are thirsting for someone to trust. They are searching for a God who is faithful. Unfortunately, many of them are searching in the wrong places, in money, pleasure, comfort, new age spirituality. Some sell many numbers of false idols. God wants to convince them of His faithfulness. He wants them to discover true hope, the hope that comes from Him, the only hope that will never let them down. So God needs us to help Him. God reveals Himself and His faithfulness to the world 2,000 years ago through to ordinary people who were poor, undereducated, working class people, Mary and Joseph. Through them, the Savior entered the world. He wants to do the same thing now, through us, through our works, example, and actions. He wants to send Jesus, the Savior, into the lives of those around us who are searching for the light. So therefore, one day, brothers and sisters, we and our loved one, all together, will live happily in the kingdom of God forever. Let us now stand together to bless our prayer. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From the end
Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Almighty and ever-living God, we give thanks for every grace you bestow on us. And also we give thanks for sending us the messenger, John the Baptist, to let us to repent our sins and turn back to you. We ask you now, once again, be mercy on us. Listen to our prayer and petition that we have just offered to you. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merit to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue, with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
to be right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him, with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist saying of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
the Saviour commanded, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. have the parents' Christmas dinner tomorrow night at 6 p.m. And also, on Wednesday we have reconciliation here at 7 p.m. Let us pray. Blessed, by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things on earth and hold firm to the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Yes,
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thank you, God.
Thank you so much, everyone. Enjoy the weekend.
Thank you, God.